Legacy versus blended retirement. Which retirement system is right for you? Imagine that this represents the path of your military career and retirement. On the left is the legacy retirement system. On the right, the new blended retirement system, or BRS. The legacy system has served the DoD well since the late 1940s. BRS, however, provides additional options to attract and manage a military force in an evolving global economy. It goes into effect in January 2018. How does it affect you? Let's take a look. Everyone currently serving as of December 31st, 2017 will be grandfathered under their current retirement plans. No one will be automatically switched to the BRS. Everyone who enters the military on or after January 1st, 2018 will be automatically enrolled in the new BRS. But some of us who are currently serving will have a choice. As of December 31st, 2017, if you are active duty and have served fewer than 12 years or are a member of the National Guard or Reserve with fewer than 4,320 retirement points, you'll have a choice to enroll in the BRS or remain covered by your current plan. Now, let's take a closer look at how opting in will work. If you're serving in the military as of December 31st, 2017, and have fewer than 12 years of service, or for National Guard and Reserve members, if you have fewer than 4,320 points, you'll take mandatory BRS opt-in training in 2017. In 2018, you can then choose between enrolling in BRS or staying with your current system. The BRS may not be right for everyone, but based on your circumstances and your career goals, it may make sense to switch. There are numerous resources available to you. Online training, the BRS resource webpage at militarypay.defense.gov/blended-retirement, the BRS comparison calculator, your installation's personal financial managers and counselors, and Military OneSource. Legacy versus blended retirement. Which retirement system is right for you?